Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kita mulakan kelas kita pada pagi ini dengan membaca Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah. A'udzubillah minasyaitanirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. Amin. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin ashrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, ampunkanlah dosa-dosa kami, ampunkanlah dosa kedua ibu bapa kami dan kasihlah mereka sebagaimana mereka mengasihi kami di masa kecil. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, kurniakanlah kepada kami ilmu yang bermanfaat untuk diri kami, keluarga kami, agama kami, bangsa kami dan negara kami. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, berilah kepada kami kejayaan di dunia dan di akhirat. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, jadikanlah kami orang-orang yang bersyukur. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina azabannar. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Alhamdulillah, kita bersyukur pada Allah SWT. Kita dapat bertemu lagi pada pagi ini. Apa khabar semua?
Alhamdulillah, baik.
Okay, sihat, bro.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, ya. So, semoga terus sihat, ya. Jadi, pada pagi ini kita nak masuk tajuk baru. Jadi, sebelum masuk tajuk baru, saya bukalah kepada apa-apa soalan yang ada, sekiranya ada. Ada apa-apa soalan?
Tak ada, Prof.
Jadi sepatutnya tajuk ni kita masuk minggu depan lah pada hari Senin, eh. Tapi Alhamdulillah kita dah dah habis semua kita punya coverage untuk agriculture. So kita bolehlah masuk ke tajuk yang berikutnya, iaitu compare and contrast, eh. Jadi compare and contrast ni saya akan share dia punya PowerPoint. Boleh nampak, ya?
Boleh, bro.
Okey, Alhamdulillah. Okey, ya. So, inilah dia. So, tajuk kita ni adalah compare and contrast, ya. So, I hope everybody understand what is the meaning of compare and what is the meaning of contrast, ya. So, compare means kita bandingkan. Kita bandingkan. Contrast ni kita bezakan. So, ada dua lah. Kita bandingkan, kita bezakan, ya. Okay. So, apa yang kita nak banding dan kita nak bezakan? Basically, we are going to compare and contrast these five MFRSs, ya. Property, plant, equipment. You have learned property, plant, equipment in FAR 270, if I'm not mistaken. And then we have learned also inventory. Inventory in which FAR, ya? Is it 160? Inventory. Ingat tak inventory? Ya, 102 itu dia punya FRS, MFRS. Dia punya FAR. Which FAR?
For 210 code, Prof.
210, eh? Okay, 210. Good. Kemudian 210 ni part 3, eh? Okey, kemudian kita ada intangible asset yang kita baru belajar. Investment property you have learned in FAR 270. And agriculture kita baru saja habis belajar pada minggu ni. Okey, so these are the assets that we have learned and we are going to compare and to contrast. Yeah. Jadi ini sebenarnya tajuk yang boleh kata paling senang lah. Kita nak compare contrast saja. Tapi kadang-kadang kita tersilap lah instead of property plant equipment, kita anggap dia sebagai investment property ataupun sebaliknya. Tapi tak apa, ya. Yeah? Okay, compare and contrast between these categories and their treatment in the financial statement. In this topic, you are going to compare and to contrast between MFRSs. You need to be well versed in all MFRSs. Maknanya yang lima tadilah, bukanlah semua bukanlah semua MFRS ya. Okey, tetapi MFRS yang 5 tadilah untuk tajuk ni, ya. Yeah. You may be given a situation ataupun a condition ataupun a circumstance. Okay, you need to be able to use the different information dalam soalan tu, yeah, given and explain the correct accounting treatment according to the correct MFRS. So before we do that, let us recall, okay, what is property, plant and equipment. Kita nak ulang kaji, kita ingat semula apakah dia property, plant and equipment. So bukan kita nak belajar property, plant and equipment, tetapi kita nak tengok overall, the overall picture of property, plant and equipment. So the MFRS related to property, plant and equipment is MFRS 116, property, plant and equipment, as well as MFRS 136, impairment. Yeah. So asset ni subject to impairment. Therefore, when we use MFRS 116, we need to also look at the MFRS 136. And then about the definition of property, plant, equipment. Property, plant, equipment are tangible assets ataupun tangible items that are held for use in the production or supply of goods or services, for rental to others or for administrative purpose, and are expected to be used during more than one accounting period. About the recognition of property, plant, equipment, it will be recognized if it is probable that the future economic benefit associated with the items will flow to the entity and the cost can be measured reliably. Okay, so if the asset ataupun the item fulfill this criteria, then we can treat the item as a property, plant and equipment. Okay, secondly, we talk about measurement. Okay, measurement, there are two types of measurement. The first one is initial measurement and the second one is subsequent measurement. About the about the initial measurement, okay, property will be initially measured at cost, and for subsequent measurement it can be measured based on cost model, and second alternative is revaluation model. Okay, so just now when we talk about recognition, I put there accounting treatment. So it means we can recognize, and yeah, we can recognize as an asset, therefore debit asset, credit bank ke ataupun credit cash ke ataupun credit account payable. Okay, kemudian measurement is about the figure. Yeah, about the figure. What is the figure? So the figure is, if it is at cost, then we take the cost, we put in the debit side and credit side. Yeah. Okay, to measurement. Kemudian yang keempat, ada yang kelima, derecognition. Derecognition. So derecognition, kalau tadi dia fulfill the requirement ni, probable future economic benefit, the cost can be measured reliably, kita recognize. Macam mana pula keadaannya kalau kita nak de-recognize? Okay, so de-recognize ni maknanya kita dah tak fulfill dia punya recognition criteria ni. So the reasons for de-recognition, number one, due to disposal. So bila kita dispose, kita de-recognize lah. Ataupun yang kedua, retirement. The asset retired. The asset is still there but retired. Retired ni maknanya bersara daripada digunakan. Okay, so accounting treatment, the carrying amount, that is the cost less accumulated depreciation of the disposed asset, will be de-recognized. De-recognized maknanya remove from the statement of financial position. Remove, kita keluarkan. Jadi remove ni bukan remove macam tu je lah, adalah debit kredit dia. Tak bolehlah kita debit saja ataupun kredit saja. In accounting, everything must be one place to be debited and one place to be credited. And then don't forget to recognize any gain or loss on disposal. And sometimes the carrying amount is still big and the recoverable amount ataupun dia punya disposal value is small. So kita akan dapat loss kat situ. But sometimes the carrying amount is already small but the disposal value is high ataupun big. So kita akan dapat gain kat situ. Kemudian disclosure notes, yeah, provide depreciation regardless of any measurement model. Okay, kita gunakan cost model ataupun gunakan revaluation model, kita tetap kena depreciate, kecuali untuk land. Ya, untuk land tak adalah disposal, tak adalah depreciation. And then provide depreciation even asset is idle. Idle ni maknanya tidak digunakan. Asset tadi tidak digunakan, still kita kena depreciate dia. Okay, so in the notes of disclosure, we need to we need to record ataupun we need to show the balance brought down, the changes as well as the balance carried out of the property plant equipment. So yang ni you dah tengok lah dalam notes to the financial statement tu, memang ada note yang khusus untuk property plant and equipment. Okay, we go to the second one, intangible asset. So intangible asset is according to MFRS 138 as well as MFRS 136 impairment, ya. Okay, and then definition. Intangible asset is assets without physical substance. Without physical substance. So, okay, kita pun baru belajar pada 2 minggu yang lepas. Recognition. There are 3 criteria for recognition. The first one is identifiability. The second one is control. And the third one is future economic benefit. Measurement. Initial measurement at cost. And subsequent measurement, we can choose either cost model or revaluation model. Okay, just like property plant equipment. Sama saja dengan property plant equipment. Kita ada 2 choice untuk model. Subsequent measurement. Kemudian di recognition. Di recognition sama juga dengan property. When an intangible asset is disposed of, yang pertama. Ataupun when an asset is permanently withdrawn from use and has no future economic value. Any gain or loss arising recognized in SOPL, any balance or revaluation reserve will be transferred to retained earning. Ini pun sama jugalah dengan property. Property pun macam tu juga. Disclosure. Okay, we need to disclose the amortization. Kemudian dalam note tu sama juga dengan property plant equipment. Kita kena tunjukkan balance brought down, any changes. Kemudian balance carried down. Okay, number 3 is investment property. Investment property, nama dia property, ya. Property is under MFRS 140, investment property. Definition is property, land or a building, or part of a building, or both, held by the owner or by the lessee under a finance lease to earn rentals or for capital appreciation or both. Okay, jadi untuk investment property tadi, dia punya purpose of holding the property is for what? For rental or for capital appreciation. Bukan semua aset adalah layak dipanggil sebagai investment property. Yang layak jadi investment property hanyalah land dengan building saja. Lain-lain, kereta sewa, boleh tak kita panggil investment property? Tak boleh. Ya, kereta sewa tak boleh. Apalagi yang kita boleh sewakan tetapi dia bukan investment property. So maknanya, ya, kereta bukanlah investment property. Property is related to land, building ataupun part of building. Recognition. It is probable that future economic benefit that are associated with the investment property will flow to the entity and the cost of the investment property can be measured reliably. Alright, and then measurement. Initial measurement at cost, just like the property plant equipment and intangible asset. However, for the subsequent measurement, we have 2 models that we can choose. That is the cost model. So kalau cost model ni, kita kena depreciate lah. Yang kedua, fair value model. Fair value model, there is no depreciation. Okay, we only compare the fair value at the beginning of the year and fair value at the end of the year, and the difference will be either a gain or a loss. Okay. And then the recognition, it will be de-recognized when the asset is disposed of or permanently withdrawn from use. Any gain or loss on disposal goes to SOPL. And lastly, disclosure notes. No depreciation for fair value model. Any difference between fair value and carrying amount is gain or loss recognized in SOPN. Next is agriculture. Second last agriculture. So agriculture baru saja kita habis belajar dua hari lepas. Agriculture under MFRS 141 agriculture. Definition. Based on the definition of agriculture in MFRS 141, agriculture ni ada a few definitions lah. Yang pertama, definition of agricultural activity. Yang keduanya, definition of biological asset. Yang ketiga adalah agricultural produce. Yang keempat adalah bearer plant. Ada empat definition penting kat situ. So, definition-definition ni penting. Okay. Kemudian yang ketiga adalah recognition. Okay. It will be recognized if the company control the asset as a result of past event. Yang keduanya, future economic benefit can be future economic benefit will flow to the entity. Yang ketiga, the cost of fair value can be measured reliably. Measurement, initial measurement at fair value less cost to sell. Subsequent measurement, fair value less cost to sell. Jadi untuk agriculture ni, kita tak ada pilihan ya. Kita kena gunakan fair value less cost to sell kecuali. Kecuali the fair value cannot be found. The fair value cannot be found. Disebabkan tidak ada market dan sebagainya. Okay, difference. Price change and physical change. Jadi, from the beginning, apa yang kita buat dalam kelas kita yang lepas, kita tengok dia punya tu ada price change dan juga ada physical change. Jadi kalau price change ni kita compare dia punya price change pada hari dilahirkan ataupun hari dibeli, kemudian kita compare dengan year end. Itulah price change dia dengan umur yang sama. Jadi kalau dia baru dilahirkan, maka kita compare dengan fair value less cost to sell pada tarikh akhir tahun. Begitu juga dengan kalau dibeli pada umur setahun setengah. Kemudian kita akan compare dengan akhir tahun punya fair value less cost to sell yang berumur setahun setengah. So itu adalah price change. Dan untuk physical change ni kita akan compare dia punya umur dia. Kalau umur kosong masa dilahirkan kepada umur pada akhir tahun. Adakah setahun ataupun 6 bulan ataupun 3 bulan. Kemudian kalau yang umur 1 tahun setengah pada awal tahun, pada akhir tahun berumur 2 tahun setengah. Jadi kita akan ambil perbezaan umur tadi sebagai apa dia? Physical change. Kemudian fair value less cost to sell kita akan ambil yang hujung tahun punyalah. Itu memang saya rasa itu masih lagi kuat dalam ingatan awak sebab kita baru saja belajar. Okay, derecognition. Bila kita dispose, kita akan derecognize. Disclosure. Disclose the aggregate gain or loss arising during the current period or initial recognition of biological asset and agricultural produce and from the change in fair value less cost to sell of the biological asset. Jadi kita akan disclose apa? Aggregate gain or losses arising during the current period on initial recognition of the biological asset. Okay. Kemudian agricultural produce pun sama juga macam tu. And from the change in fair value less cost to sell. Dan last kali inventory. So inventory sebagaimana awak sebut tadi, awak belajar masa FAR 2010. Okay. According to MFRS 102 definition, inventory ni asset held for sale in ordinary course of business. Ataupun yang keduanya in the process of production for such sale. Yang ni work in progress. Ataupun yang ketiga material in the form of materials or supplies to be consumed in the production process or in the rendering of services. Recognition, carried at cost until sold. So kita akan carry the at cost. Kalau beli pada harga RM5, kita akan bawa lah harga RM5 tadi sampai kita jual. The carrying amount of those inventory should be recognized as an expense Apabila kita jual, barulah kita recognize as an expense. Jadi, sebelum kita jual, kita tak recognize sebagai expense. Kita recognize sebagai asset. Kemudian kalau perlu, kita akan write down if the net realizable value is lower than the cost, then we need to write down the cost. Okay. Dan kita juga boleh reverse dia punya write down apabila dia punya harga naik semula, NRV naik semula, maka kita reverse kita punya write down. Measurement. MFRS 102, inventory shall be measured at the lower of cost and net realizable value. Always take the lower. Derecognition, inventory will be derecognized when they are sold. And disclosure notes, inventory is carried at fair value less cost to sell. The amount of write down value in SOPN. Ini yang kita kena disclose ya. Inventory is carried at fair value less cost to sell. Yang pertama. Yang kedua, the amount of write down value in SOPN. So these are the revision for property plant equipment, for investment property, intangible asset, agriculture, inventory. Okay, jadi kita revision lah, revision saja. Bukan kita nak belajar semula yang ni, kita dah belajar. Okay, jadi ada apa-apa soalan berkaitan dengan ini sebelum kita masuk kepada sample question?
Setakat ni tak ada, Prof.
Okay, setakat ni tak ada ya. Okay, so kita dah teruskan kepada sample question ya. Okay, sample question ni saya bagi dalam WhatsApp. Okay. On 1st January 2016, Kasih Putih Berhad acquired an asset at the cost of 50,000. The fair value of the asset at 31st December 2016 and 31st December 2017 were 80,000 and 55,000 respectively. Revaluation model was adopted for property plant equipment. Fair value model was adopted for investment property and biological asset. Its property, plant and equipment is to be depreciated over useful life of 5 years. Okay, saya akan tambah sikit kat sini. Valuation model, property, plant, equipment. Okay. And intangible asset. And fair value model was adopted. And fair value model was adopted for investment property and biological asset. Kemudian, investment property. Okay, it's property plant equipment. And intangible asset. To be depreciated. Depreciated, kalau intangible ni bukan depreciated lah, kita panggil amortize. Over useful life of 5 years. Okay. So berdasarkan pada soalan ni jadi maknanya soalan ni, dalam soalan ni the question does not mention what asset the company is purchasing Dia tak beritahu, dia kata dia beli aset saja. We are the one who will determine whether the asset is investment property or property plant equipment or investment property or agriculture or inventory. Kitalah yang kita kena identify. Soalan dia cuma bagi tahu macam tu saja. Okay. So, number one ataupun A, required. Assuming the acquired asset was an exotic parrot that the entity breeds for sale. Number one, state the relevant MFRS in order to recognize the asset. And number two, explain the accounting treatment of the asset for the year ended 31st December 2016 and 31st December 2017. Okay. Jadi apakah dia MFRS yang sesuai untuk burung parrot ni? Parrot ni dalam bahasa Melayu burung apa ya? Burung. Apa tu yang dia punya paruh dia bengkok tu apa dia? Ingat nama
burung
dia?
Burung kakak tua.
Ha, burung kakak tua. Ha, betul. Burung kakak tua dah lama tak sebut, okey. Ha, dulu ada lagu burung kakak tua. Okey. Ha, jadi burung kakak tua ni, MFRS apa yang sesuai untuk burung kakak tua? Is it PPE? Or agriculture? Or investment property? Or inventory? Or intangible asset?
States agriculture, bro.
Agriculture.
Okay, agriculture. Very good. Boleh ingat lagi eh. So, kita cerita tentang animal kan? Kita cerita tentang animal. Jadi, especially kat sini, exotic parrot eh. The entity breeds for sale. Okay. Jadi, harga dia RM50,000 tu. RM50,000 ya. Okay. So, betul jawapan dia. Kemudian, yang kedua, explain the accounting treatment of the asset for the year ended 31st December 2016 and 31st December 2017. Ya, macam mana kita nak treat ya, asset tadi in accounting. Especially selepas kita beli tu, dia punya value tu naik kepada 80 dan kemudian turun kepada 55. So, let's look at the answer. Okay, eh. So, MFRS dia betul, agriculture. Okay, macam mana kita nak trade dia, accounting treatment dia. The initial cost of the biological asset was $50,000. Ataupun kita boleh kata, the asset can be recognized as a biological asset under MFRS 141 at $50,000. For the year ended 31st December 2016, there was a gain of $30,000. And there was a gain of $30,000. Why? Because the value change from 50,000 to 80,000. 50,000 is the cost, yeah, initial cost. 80,000 is the fair value at the end of the year. Jadi fair value ni adalah fair value less cost to sell. Okay, so 30,000 is the gain. Okay. For the year ended 31st December 2017, there was a loss of 25,000. Loss pula. Why loss? Because we are comparing the new fair value 55,000 and the carrying amount 80,000. So kita dapat loss pula 25,000. Gains are to be credited into SOPL and loss are to be debited to SOPL as an expense in the respective years. Jadi pada tahun 2016 kita record gain, kita credit to SOPL. Dan pada tahun 2017, kita record a loss dan kita debit to SOPL as an expense. Is that okay, kelas?
Yes.
Okay, Prof. Faham, Prof.
Ya, ya. Jadinya kita inilah maksudnya compare and contrast. So, dalam soalan dia tak bagi tahu. Ya, yeah? Dia tak bagi tahu which type of asset, which MFRS. So, kita yang identify. So after we identify, barulah kita boleh create dia punya accounting treatment. Okay, eh? So kita pergi pada situation yang kedua. Situation yang kedua, dia kata assuming the asset was a building used for admin purpose. A building used for admin purpose. State the relevant MFRS in order to recognize the asset. Senanglah kan? Okay, what is the MFRS?
116.
MFRS 116, property, plant and equipment. So how are we going to treat the property, plant and equipment with regards the accounting treatment ni? Sebelum kita tengok jawapan, agaknya kita nak buat macam mana? Remember that property, plant and equipment is using revaluation model. So adakah jawapan dia sama dengan jawapan A tadi? Ada RM30,000 gain, ada RM25,000 loss. ataupun lain jawapan dia. Of course lah, kita kena, kita kena kira lah eh. Kita kena kira, jadi kita gunakan revaluation model, maknanya bermula dengan cost, kemudian kita calculate dia punya depreciation, kemudian kita dapatkan carrying amount, kemudian kita compare carrying amount dengan fair value, dapatlah dia punya revaluation. Okay, kemudian pada tahun yang kedua kita gunakan revaluation tu sebagai apa ni, carrying amount, kemudian kita calculate dia punya depreciation for the year, kemudian kita dapatkan fair value yang kedua, kita compare, lepas tu kita dapatlah fair value ataupun kita revaluation gain ataupun deficit, okay, surplus ataupun deficit on revaluation. Okay, ya. So kita dah tahu apakah dia punya MFRS. MFRS is property plant equipment. Yang kita kena bincang adalah accounting treatment dia. So as at 31st December 2016, there is a surplus on revaluation on the building amounting to 40,000. Yeah. How do we get 40,000? Basically, we are comparing the fair value 80,000 with the carrying amount. Carrying amount dia adalah 50,000 minus 10,000. Sebab apa kita minus 10,000? 10,000 tu adalah depreciation, kan? Ya, yeah, 10,000 adalah depreciation. Jadi kalau kita nak buat booking sikit pun boleh kat sini. Ya, yeah, kita tunjukkan booking sikit. Cost, ya, yeah, cost dia 50,000. Accumulated depreciation, okay, 10,000. Mana dapat 10,000? 10 bagi 5. Carrying amount 50,000. Bila kita nak buat jalan panjang lah, ya, biasa kita buat macam tu. Kemudian kita compare dengan fair value 80,000. So surplus on revaluation, first adalah 40,000. Ya. Yeah. So itulah dia jawapan dia. Okay. Kemudian ya, yeah, at 31st December 2017, deficit on the revaluation was 5,000. Why 5,000? Because the new fair value is 55,000 and the new carrying amount is 80,000 divided by 4, ya. Yeah. 80,000 divided by 4. Jadi kita kira semula lah kat bawah ni. Okay, punya carrying amount tadi, fair value dah jadi carrying amount sekarang. Carrying amount 1,1,317, 80,000. Depreciation 10 bagi 4. Carrying amount 31st December 60,000. Fair value 55,000. Revaluation deficit So itulah jawapan dia. Jadi okay, untuk yang 40,000 tadi, kita credit to asset revaluation reserve. Manakala untuk yang 5,000 tadi, kita debit to asset revaluation reserve. Ya, yeah, kita reverse balik asset revaluation reserve kita sebanyak 5,000 eh. Sebab apa? Sebab kita punya revaluation yang pertama adalah surplus. So, bila revaluation yang kedua adalah deficit, kita akan reverse setakat mana yang deficit tu. Okay. Di baki revaluation reserve eh, ada 35 lagi selepas daripada deposit on revaluation in 2017. Okay. Seterusnya, kita tengok soalan yang berikutnya. Soalan yang ketiga, C. Okay. Assuming the acquired asset was a land for undetermined use. Undetermined future use. So, state the relevant MFRS in order to recognize the asset. MFRS yang mana? Undetermined future use land. Which MFRS?
Investment property.
Investment property MFRS 1. 100 berapa?
140
investment property eh. Okay, betul jawapan dia. Explain the accounting treatment of the asset for the year ended 31st December 2016 and 31st December 2017. So according to the question, investment property is using fair value model. Ni okay, dia kata fair value model for investment property. Jadi dia macam mana kita nak buat treatment dia? How to treat the investment property in the year 2016? Anybody? There is an increase, right? From 50,000 to 80,000. Ya, yeah, 50,000 to 80,000. Itu 31st December 2016. Kemudian 31st December 2017 reduce to 55,000. Okay, jadi kat situ kita dah tahulah investment property ni bila kita gunakan fair value, dia bukan macam revaluation model. Eh, revaluation model kita ada depreciation. Okay. Tetapi fair value tak ada depreciation. We just compare the fair value and fair value. The old fair value and the new fair value. Okay. So initially recognize at cost of 50,000. And then at the end of the year, the value increase to 80,000. So there is a surplus. Ha, tapi surplus dalam investment property ni kita tak panggil surplus, kita panggil gain. Ha, kalau revaluation kita panggil surplus eh. Kalau fair value kita panggil gain. So MFRS investment property based on fair value model, investment property is not depreciated eh, for the year ended 31st December 2016. Gain of 30,000, that is the difference between 80,000 and 50,000, was credited to SOPL. Okay. And for the year ended 31st December 2017, a loss of 25,000, that is the difference between 55,000 and 80,000, was debited to SOPL as an expense. Itu saja. Okay. Jadi kalau nak panjang-panjangkan lagi, boleh juga kan? Kita boleh panjangkan lagi ayat-ayat ni. Tapi untuk ni memadailah, kita ada kita kata okay, ada gain yeah, sebanyak 30,000 2016 dan ada loss sebanyak 25,000 in the year 2017. Okay. Okay, macam mana pula keadaannya kalau aset ini, aset yang kita beli tadi adalah intangible asset pula. Yeah, kalau aset yang kita beli tadi intangible pula. Katalah dia intangible pula. Saya bagi contohlah kat sini. Yeah. Sebenarnya soalan dia sampai soalan C saja. So kalau kita tambah sikit, assuming the acquired asset was a special machine for resale. So dia adalah MFRS 102. Kita beli mesin ke kita beli barang yang lain untuk tujuan jual semula. Yeah, for the purpose of resale, untuk jual semula. So itu adalah inventory. Accounting treatment. So kalau accounting treatment untuk tadi tu pada tahun 2016, the cost is 50,000. NRV is 80,000. Inventory is measured at the lower of cost and net realizable value. Therefore, the carrying amount of the inventory is 50,000 untuk 2016. Untuk 2017, kekal juga sebagai 50,000 sebab dia adalah the lower of cost and net realizable value. Jadi, berbeza dengan investment property, berbeza dengan property plant equipment, yeah, berbeza dengan agriculture. Yeah, sebab apa? Sebab inventory ini formula dia adalah the lower of cost and net realizable value. Yang lain-lain tu kita ambil fair value yang terbaru. Ha, tapi kita formula untuk inventory kekal. Yeah, the lower of cost and net realizable value. Let's say the net realizable value is 40,000 untuk 2017. Ha, masa tu barulah kita tukar daripada 50 kepada 40. Maknanya kita ada write down the cost from 50,000 to 40,000. Okay, itu kalau inventory. Yeah. Macam mana pula kalau dia ni adalah patent? Kalau dia adalah patent pula macam mana? Intangible asset. So intangible asset kita gunakan revaluation model sama dengan property plant equipment. Okay, ini hanyalah sebahagian daripada soalan sikit saja. Nanti pada kelas yang akan datang insyaAllah pada hari Senin kita akan tengok soalan yang lebih banyak lagi. Okay, so saya rasa setakat itu sajalah dulu kelas kita pada hari ini. Ada apa-apa soalan?
Prof, maksudnya yang tadi soalan yang bahagian investment property dengan agriculture tu calculation dia sama je lah kan Prof?
Kalau kita nak kata sama tu untuk soalan ni samalah. Yeah? Tapi kalau mungkin soalan akan datang, soalan yang berbeza tu mungkin jawapan dia tak mestilah sama. Dari segi prinsip dia sama. Yeah? Sebab kita punya tu adalah kita compare fair value dengan fair value kan untuk investment property dan juga untuk agriculture. Jadi untuk soalan ni jawapan dia memang sama. Okay. Itu betul jawapan awak tadi. Soalan awak tu betul lah. Ada lagi soalan? Okay, jangan lupa untuk isi attendance. Setakat ni baru 18 yang isi. Ada lagi apa-apa soalan?
Setakat ni tak ada Prof.
Okay, so kalau tak ada, kita akhiri kelas kita pada pagi lagi ni, pagi-pagi ini. Kita sudahi dengan surah Al-As. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wal-asri innal insana lafi husr ila allazina amanu wa amilus salihat. Wa tawassaw bil haqq wa tawassaw bis sabr. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.